shortly after 11 o'clock, comedy struck this little house in Dibley Road. Sudden, violent comedy. Police have sealed off the area, and Scotland Yard's crack inspector is with me now.
I shall enter the house and attempt to remove the joke. I shall be aided by the sound of somber music played on gramophone records and also by the chanting of laments by the men of Q Division. The atmosphere thus created should protect me in the eventuality of me reading the joke.
Comes out alive or not, this will surely be remembered as one of the most courageous and gallant acts in police history.
It was not long before the army became interested in the military potential of the killer joke. Under top security, the joke was hurried to a meeting of Allied commanders at the Ministry of War. Top brass were impressed. Tests on Salisbury Plain confirmed the joke's devastating effectiveness at a range of up to 50 yards.
Through the winter of 43, we had translators working in joke-proof conditions to try and produce a German version of the joke. They worked on one word each for greater safety. One of them saw two words of the joke and spent several weeks in hospital. But apart from that, things went pretty quickly. And we soon had the joke by January in a form which our troops couldn't understand, but which the Germans could.
So on July the 8th, 1944, the joke was first told to the enemy in the Ardennes. It was a fantastic success, over 60,000 times as powerful as Britain's great pre-war joke, and one which Hitler just couldn't match.
Insbesondere, keine mehr da in Deutschland leben wird.
Wir sind des Reiches junge Mannschaft.
Eure Schule.
In action, it was deadly.
Wenn ich das nur so, geht uns noch einmal. Ja, warum?
Ja!
German casualties were appalling.
What is the big joke?
I can only give you a name, rank, and why did the chicken cross the road?
That's not funny! I want to know the joke!
All right. How do you make a Nazi cross?
I don't know. How do you make a Nazi cross?
Tread on his corn.
God in Himmel! That's not funny! Now, if you don't tell me the joke, I shall hit you properly.
I can stand physical pain, you know.
Ach, you're no fun. All right, Otto!
Oh, no. No, anything but that, please.
She's got
all right. I'll tell you.
Quick, Otto, the typewriter.
Ben, ist das Lötstück Jet und Slottemeyer. Ja, bei Hund das Öder, die Flipperwald, Gashput.
That's not funny!
The Germans were working on a joke of their own.
Die ist ein Kinderhunde und zwei Mackerlöwe und der Bitteschön ist ein Wunderhaus, schrecken Sie. Nein, schreckte Herren, ist auch ein Burger mit zwei Dingen.
We let you know.
Hitler gave the order, but by December, their joke was ready, and Hitler gave the order for the German V-joke to be broadcast in English.
There were three peanuts walking down the Strasse, and one was assaulted. Peanut.
In 1945, peace broke out. It was the end of the joke. Joke warfare was banned at a special session of the Geneva Convention, and in 1950, the last remaining copy of the joke was laid to rest here in the Berkshire countryside, never to be told again.
And here is the final score, pigs 9, British bipeds 4. The pigs go on to meet Vicky Carr in the final.